Have you ever wondered how it is we know what we know about the world? Why is it, for example, that we can send a mass spectrometer thousands, millions, how many miles, so many miles into space to land on Mars? And that instrument can measure the elemental composition of the rocks and soils, and then we can beam those data back to Earth? And we've been doing that since the 1970s. Or think about the fact that we can send a submersible down to the bottom of the ocean, and it can float around and beam back video of beautiful ocean creatures. And scientists can sit at their desks and look at it, and you and I can sit on our computers and watch the scientists ooh and ah over the beautiful new creature that they found. We all know that science and technology are intimately linked. And when we have technological advances, we also have scientific advances. However, access to technology is not equal. And there are many people who don't have access to all of the amazing technological resources that some people have. This is a problem. It's a problem that wakes me up at night. It's a problem that gets me up at 3 a.m. sometimes. It's a problem because we know from lots of different studies that having a diverse group work on a project ultimately results in the best results. But if we are using technology and the cost of technology as a gatekeeper to who can ask and answer scientific questions, then we are not getting the entire view of the world that we should have. My passion is for coastal ecosystems, and I kind of want your passion to be for coastal ecosystems too. So let's give you a few facts so that you can just keep them in your back pocket, okay? We are a coastal civilization. Why is that? Well, because we rely on coastal ecosystems and we have done so for millennia. And if we have any hope of dealing with climate change, then we're going to need coastal ecosystems now more than ever. Over 3 billion people live within 100 kilometers of the coast, with 1 billion of those people living just 10 meters above the high tide line. Coastal ecosystems are profoundly important for our global economy. And each year, they add somewhere between $3 and $6 trillion to that economy. We rely on coastal ecosystems for nutrition. Nutrition from finfish and shellfish. In the US alone, 85% of the fish that we eat comes from coastal ecosystems. And of course, we enjoy them because we like to recreate there. Kayak, swim, surf, walk along the beach with your loved one. We also, many of us, have deep cultural and spiritual connections to the ocean through coastal ecosystems. Are you convinced yet? Maybe? Okay. There are other benefits that you may not be familiar with that are profoundly important, especially now. Many of the coastal ecosystems that we need do wonderful things like protect people from storm surge. They filter pollutants and they sequester carbon. You may have heard of this before, blue carbon. It's a big thing right now, and it should be. There's big prizes out there being offered, $100 million or so, to figure out how to sequester carbon. Here's the answer. Rebuild these ecosystems. Marine systems are really good at sequestering carbon, especially these. Tidal marshes, seagrass meadows, and mangroves. Of course, and unfortunately, because of our reliance on these systems and their close proximity to where humans live and act, our actions are causing major destruction. I'm going to give you some depressing numbers. We have lost over 50% of our mangroves. We have lost up to 65% of our seagrass meadows and up to 80% of our tidal marshes. So all of those amazing benefits, from habitat for fish that we depend on, from nutrition and the economy, to storm surge protection and blue carbon, get lost when we destroy these ecosystems. Are you feeling a little depressed? It's okay. There's a way out. The way out is to figure out how we can best manage and protect them. And the neat thing is, we think that we can couple the management, protection, and restoration of these ecosystems, the restoration of all the many benefits they provide, including the sequestration of carbon, to that first problem that I mentioned, by increasing access to technology in a novel way. I am leading a group with colleagues at Boston University and Harvard University to radically change how we approach coastal ocean research. Our goal is to develop a novel sensor suite, but it's not just about developing a novel sensor suite. It's about taking that technology and putting it into the hands of more people. Our worldview is limited by those who get to ask and answer questions. And our goal is to expand those people, expand the pool, bring the most pressing questions, more diversity in the ways, all of the ways we can define that, to the table to answer these pressing questions. How are we going to do it? We're going to build on the familiar tenets of the share economy. Many of us routinely do things like rent a tuxedo for the weekend. I don't rent a tuxedo, although I would like one, actually. But you might rent a bike for a quick tour around Boston, right? Well, imagine if it was possible to do that for sensors. That's our goal. We're going to leverage the very best we can from the share economy. We're going to be able to share the novel sensor suites that we develop, and we will increase the data that we need. So here we're solving the problems that we have at hand. We're going to increase who is asking and answering questions, increase access to the scientific enterprise. We will collect more and better data on spatial and temporal parameters that we need to build better predictive models so that we can build a sustainable future for coastal ecosystems. Those models and those data can also help inform how to make the best management and policy decisions for the restoration of these coastal ecosystems. By restoring coastal ecosystems, we can continue the partnership that humans and the coast have had for millennia. I strongly believe that the future of coastal ecosystems is also the future of humanity. And our path forward, our sustainable path forward, is to improve how we take care and manage these systems. It would be wonderful if you would like to learn more and join us. Please come to coastalocean.org. Thank you very much.